Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chanzo. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 26th of April. India reports record COVID-19 cases for fifth day. Oxygen shortage continues. US NATO forces preparing for withdrawal, says Commander Miller. And Nepal's Kathmandu Valley bears cleaner looks after weeks of pollution. And now for all the details. India's coronavirus cases hit a record peak for a fifth day on Monday, with over 352,900 fresh infections in the last 24 hours. The international community, including Britain, the US and Germany, have pledged to send urgent medical aid to help tackle the crisis as hospitals across India are running out of medical oxygen and beds.
The COVID-19 situation in India continues to remain grim as the country on Monday recorded yet again the highest single-day spike with 352,991 new COVID-19 cases in the past 24 hours, taking the infections tally to 17.31 million. Amid the alarming surge, overcrowded hospitals in capital New Delhi and elsewhere are forced to turn away patients after running out of supplies of medical oxygen and beds. People were seen arranging stretchers and oxygen cylinders outside hospitals as they desperately pleaded for authorities to take patients in.
I have been here for 2 hours. और देख लो दो ढाई घंटे हो गए, अभी एक घंटा और लंबा नहीं मेरा आने का। तो हमारे पास तो चलो गाड़ी है, मैं उसमें बैठा हूँ, जो जिसके पास गाड़ी नहीं है वो कहाँ बैठेगा बेचारे का।
India's Prime Minister Narendra Modi in a radio address on Sunday said storm of infections had shaken India. Countries including Britain, France, Germany, Singapore and the United States have pledged to send urgent medical aid to help India tackle the crisis. India airlifted some medical supplies from Singapore on late Sunday night, while in the rest of the country, trains are running, carrying the life gas to the overburdened states amid oxygen scarcity.
Voting for the seventh phase of assembly election in West Bengal state began at 7 a.m. local time on Monday. The Bengal elections are being held under the shadow of the second COVID-19 wave that has hit the state hard. Over 8.6 million voters will decide the fate of 284 candidates contesting from 34 assembly seats. Among the key battlegrounds is West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee's former seat, Bhavanipur. Voting took place under heightened security cover to maintain peace as well as adherence to COVID-appropriate protocol. Ruling Trinamool Congress Party and BJP are contesting on all 34 seats. Congress, the left parties and the Indian Secular Front have made a coalition and are contesting under the banner of Sanyukta Mocha. Polling for the eighth and final phase will be held on April 29, while the counting of votes will take place on May 2nd.
To vote train in front of people is to stay indoors, to take care of themselves, because we are going through a very tough situation. And on that note, I am also personally doing all virtual campaigning at the moment. For today being the last day of campaigns, we're all going virtual. So I would actually request people to stay indoors and take care of themselves.
In news from Afghanistan, the US and NATO forces commander in Afghanistan, General Austin Scott Miller, has informed that the United States and coalition forces have started the process of troop withdrawal from Afghanistan and they will continue to support their Afghan counterparts. The Taliban and the United States last year agreed that all foreign forces would be withdrawn from Afghanistan by May 1, a date that was pushed back last week by US President Joe Biden.
the US and NATO forces commander in Afghanistan, General Austin Scott Miller, has said that the United States and coalition forces have started the process of troops withdrawal from Afghanistan and they will continue to support their Afghan counterparts. Miller on Sunday said, "I will conduct an orderly withdrawal from Afghanistan and that means transitioning bases and equipment to Afghan security forces," local media reported. This came as Turkey, Pakistan and Afghanistan called on the Afghan Taliban last week to reaffirm its commitment to achieving a negotiated settlement for lasting peace in Afghanistan. A US-backed Afghan peace conference to be held in Istanbul, hosted by Turkey, Qatar and the United Nations on April 24, was postponed over the Taliban's non-participation. Local media reports suggest that the talks will be held after the Islamic fasting month of Ramadan, but no new date has been confirmed. The Taliban had earlier refused to attend any summits until all foreign forces were pulled out of Afghanistan. The Taliban and the United States last year agreed that all the foreign forces would be withdrawn from Afghanistan by May 1, a date that was pushed back last week by US President Joe Biden.
Moving on, a protest was recently held by activists to demand political rights for the people of Gilgit-Baltistan, which they said are being denied to them. They blamed while Islamabad claims of granting autonomy to the illegally occupied region on international forums, the ground reality is totally different.
A protest was recently held by activists of Karakoram National Movement to demand political rights for the people of Gilgit-Baltistan, which they said are being denied to them, while Islamabad claims internationally of granting autonomy to the illegally occupied region. They blame Pakistan government's recent move to arbitrarily grant provisional provincial status to Gilgit-Baltistan is aimed at tightening its grip on the region. They said this might be the beginning of the end of Gilgit-Baltistan and its people.
क्योंकि पाकिस्तान को सीपेक के लिए ये रूट चाहिए क्योंकि पाकिस्तान को हमारे पानी चाहिए क्योंकि पाकिस्तान को यहाँ की राहदारियाँ चाहिए वो हमारे अवाम के जज्बात को नज़रअंदाज करते हुए अपने मुफादात को सामने रख के या तरफा तौर पर इस इलाके को अबूरी आइनी सुबह बनाने का एक फार्मूला हमारे ऊपर मुसलत कर रही है और उसके लिए नामनाहत असम्बली के जो मेम्बर बैठे हुए उनसे करारदादों पर अंगूठे लगा रही है.
The activists have blamed Pakistan's all-weather friend China has been lobbying it to gain complete political control over the illegally occupied region for its strategic and ambitious China-Pakistan economic corridor. Locals blame Pakistan and China have been ruthlessly plundering large swathes of land for the multi-billion dollar project.
In news from Sri Lanka, Sri Lankan lawmaker Rishad Bataudin and his brother Riyad were arrested by the country's police over the weekend for allegedly assisting the terrorist responsible for the deadly April 2019 bombing attacks as pressure on authorities mounted to expedite its investigations into bombing. The arrest came days after head of Sri Lanka's Roman Catholic Church, Cardinal Malcolm, accused the government of allowing investigations to stall. Sri Lankan police on Saturday arrested All Ceylon Makkal Congress leader and opposition lawmaker Rishad Bathiyudin and his brother Riyaj Bathiyudin in connection with the April 2019 Easter Sunday attacks. The Bathiyudin brothers were arrested by the Criminal Investigation Department CID on charges of aiding and abetting the suicide bombers of the Easter attack and will be held for a period of 72 hours for interrogation as per the provisions of the Prevention of Terrorism Act. On April 21, Sri Lanka marked the second anniversary of the ghastly suicide bomb attacks carried out by a network of suicide bombers from an Islamic State-inspired local radical Islamist group, which killed more than 260 people and injured about 500 others. The arrest of the Bathiyudin brothers comes amid growing calls from the Catholic Church and political opposition for the government to expedite and complete the probe into the incident, a bold pledge of President Gotabaya Rajapaksa. Earlier, the head of Sri Lanka's Roman Catholic Church, Cardinal Malcolm, had also accused the government of allowing investigations to stall. Moving on to news from Nepal. Nepal's Kathmandu Valley, which was covered with a thick layer of haze and pollution in early April, now bears a cleaner look after recent rainfall and winds. Kathmandu Valley claimed the title of most polluted city in the world for weeks as its air quality index hit more than 400 micrograms per cubic meter in the first week of January this year.
Kathmandu Valley in Nepal, which was covered with a thick layer of haze and pollution in early April, now bears a cleaner look after recent rainfall and winds. Mountain ranges smiled along the northern sides of the bowl-shaped Kathmandu Valley, which was earlier choked with heavy smoke triggered by wildfires around the nation.
पुरा हिमाल देखिरहेछ सफा देखिरहेछ पुरा घाम लागिरहेछ एकदम रमाइलो देखिरहेछ नि त
Kathmandu Valley claimed the title of most polluted city in the world for weeks as its air quality index hit more than 400 micrograms per cubic meter in the first week of January this year. Choking levels of hazardous substances in the air prompted the government to close down all the educational institutions for 4 days in the last week of March.
In remote southwest Pakistan, where in many villages, internet access is almost non-existent, Roshan the camel brings books to children who can no longer go to school because of coronavirus lockdown. Roshan carries the books to 4 different villages where children borrow books and return them the next time it visits. Roshan the camel is on an important mission. He purposely plods through the arid desert terrain of Balochistan province in Pakistan, his broad feet sinking into the hot sand at every step. Roshan carries the books to 4 different villages in the district of Kutch, making the journey on alternate weekdays. The library is open for 2 to 3 hours from around 3 p.m. to 6 p.m. and children choose the books they like and return them when the library comes again. In March 2020, with the COVID-19 pandemic raging across the country, Pakistan closed its schools, sending over 50 million school and university-going students home, to the dismay of tens of thousands of parents and people connected with the education system. Rahima Jalal, principal of Zubaida Jalal Girls High School, who founded the Camel Library project with her sister, a federal minister, says she started the library last August because she wanted children around her remote hometown to continue learning despite schools being closed.
इस वक्त चला रहे हैं इसको एक बहुत छोटा सा बजट है हमारा मंथली 18,000 में तो हमें अगर डोनेशन मिल गई और बुक्स मिल गई तो हम इसको 4 गांवों से ज़्यादा बढ़ाकर बल्कि 40 गांवों तक हम पहुँचा देंगे इस वक्त तहसील मंद में ये कैमल काम कर रहा है तो हम तहसील तुम्प है तहसील दश्त है इसको मजीद फैलाएंगे क्योंकि लोगों को बहुत पसंद है और बच्चे भी बहुत खुश हैं इससे
द विलेज स्कूल्स हैव रीओपन बट लोकल ऑफिशियल्स से दे हैव रिसीव्ड मेनी मोर रिक्वेस्ट फॉर द लाइब्रेरी टू कंटिन्यू इन स्पाइट ऑफ द रिसम्पशन A Sikh temple in the outskirts of the Indian capital is giving a new lease of life to COVID-19 patients gasping for breath by providing oxygen langar or free oxygen supply. Breathless patients in need of oxygen have kept arriving at the Gurdwara since the news about the initiative spread on social media last week.
As hospitals in New Delhi scramble to find oxygen supplies, A Sikh temple in the outskirts of the Indian capital is giving a new lease of life to COVID-19 patients gasping for breath by providing oxygen langar or free oxygen supply. Members of Gurdwara Shri Guru Singh Sabha Indirapuram in northern Ghaziabad city along with their non-governmental organization Khalsa Help International have started the unique initiative to provide free oxygen to patients whose saturation levels have dropped significantly. One of the volunteers said they provide oxygen cylinders to the patients until their oxygen levels revive.
इसलिए आना पड़ा कि और कहीं व्यवस्था नहीं हो पाई तो यहाँ से पता लगा कि गुरप्रीत जी ये बहुत अच्छा काम करा रहे हैं सर। मैं यहाँ पहले पूछ के गया उन्होंने कि तुरंत लेके आओ, अगर ऐसी समस्या है तो हम इसी काम के लिए रहते हुए।
Breathless patients seeking oxygen have kept arriving at the Gurudwara since the news about the initiative spread on social media last week, with many applauding them and many offering their help to the cause. The volunteers claim that they have been able to save around 700 patients so far, but unfortunately some did not survive.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.